Welcome to Digital Learning Department of Collegiate Education. Dear students, I continue from the last video. This is part 4. In this part 4, I discuss about international accounting standards which are issued by IASC. International accounting standards means it is not an Indian accounting standards. Okay, one. It is an international accounting standards which are issued by IASC. IASC means what? Is International Accounting Standards Committee. International Accounting Standards Committee. Therefore, these International Accounting Standards, which are related to foreign country, means national level, not Indian. It is Indian accounting standards are AS 3.3, AS 1, AS 2, and international accounting standards are treated as IAS 1, IAS 2, 3.3. IAS means International Accounting Standards. See, IAS 1, IAS 2, IAS 3, these are nothing but International Accounting Standards 1, International Accounting Standards 2, itara. Idu ostane just explanation, not needed, only points on matra nanu telikolta idini. IAS 1, Disclosure of Accounting Policies, that is established in 1975. And in this, we frame standards and guidelines related to accounting policies. IAS 2, Valuation and Presentation of Inventories in the Context of Historical Cost System, that is developed in 1976. What are the standards or guidelines related to this IAS 2? It is developed in 1976. In IAS 3, what are the Consolidated Financial Statements, 1976 early, established policies and the frame. And IAS 4, it is related to deposition of accounting. In 1976, the standards are followed or developed related to deposition accounting. IAS 5, information to be disclosed in financial statements, means what are the information to be disclosed in financial statements like profit and loss account and balance sheet and etc. In this is developed in 1976. In this, actually, number of standards are fixed related to disclosure in financial statements. And another one point, IAS 6, Accounting Responses to Changing Prices, that is 1977. This is the established in 1977. IAS 7, Statement of Changes in Financial Position, that is mainly cash flow statements, that is what are the standards or guidelines or strategies related to cash flow statements, which are established in 1977. IAS 8, Unusual and Prior Period Items, Changes in Accounting Policies. This is net profit or loss for the period and fundamental errors, changes in accounting policies. This is 1978. IAS 9, Accounting for Research and Development Activities, R&D, that is developed in 1978. In that, provide number of norms and policies related to research and development. And IAS 10, that is contingencies and events occurring after the balance sheet date, means after completion of balance sheet date, what are the contingencies occurred. For that, the standards or guidelines are which are framed in 1978 and established in 1978. And IAS 11, Accounting for Construction Contract, it is established in 1979. And IAS 12, Accounting for Taxes on Income, means how the income is taxed. That for that policies and strategies or guidelines which are framed in 1979 and established in 1979. And IAS 13, Presentation of Current Assets and Current Liabilities, how the current assets and current liabilities are presented in balance sheet. For that, what are the policies, what are the guidelines, that should be shown in 1979 in IAS 13. And IAS 14, Reporting Financial Information by Segment, this is established in 1981. And IAS 15, Information Reflecting the Effects of Changing Prices. What is the pricing changes? For that, what are the effects? What are the policies are framed for that? What is the standards are fixed? That is framed in IAS 15, established in 1981. And IAS 16, Accounting for Property, Plant and Equipment, means fixed assets actually. This is what are the standards or policies or strategies or guidelines related to this one is provided in IAS 16 and established in 1982. IAS 17, Accounting for Leases, it is established in 1982. Leases sambandhapatta standards anna illi kottidare. And IAS 18, Revenue Recognition, very important revenue recognition. What are the revenue recognition are there? in 1982, that is established. And IAS 19, accounting for retirement benefits in financial statements of employers, that is 1983 is established. IAS 20, accounting for government grants and disclosure of government assistance, this is established in 1983. This is government health grants and our policies and standards are fixed by them. And what is called IAS 21, accounting for the effects of changes in foreign exchange rates, means foreign exchange rates among the aim efforts of the changes among the other policies strategies. IAS 21 and 1983 established. IAS 22 and 1983 established related to accounting for business combinations. Business combinations means business entities are the sole trading partnership firm. Our combination sambandha patante either the standards are fixed. And IS 23, capitalization of borrowing cost, that is established in 1984. And IS 24, related to quarterly disclosures, this is also related to established in 1984. Related to quarterly disclosures, sambandha policies and strategies are fixed in that IS 24. IS 25, accounting for investments, means for investments, what type of accounts are maintained? For that, policies and guidelines which are framed in IAS 25, this is established in 1986. And IAS 26, accounting for reporting by retirement benefit plans, means retirement benefit plans to employees. Employees have the retirement benefit plan for graduate if in others. Other sambandha patta standards and guidelines which are fixed in IAS 26, this is established in 1987. And IAS 27 is established in 1989. It is consolidated financial statements and accounting for investment in subsidiaries. Idu IAS 27. And IAS 28 is established in 1989, accounting for investments in associates. What is the investment in associates? Adu sambandhapatta the policies and the frame made. And accounting standard, what you call it, sorry, Indian International Accounting Standards 29 is established in 1989. Financial reporting in hyperinflation economy sambandha patta standards and policies and strategies are reported in IAS 29. And IAS 30, it is disclosures in the financial statements of banks, similar financial institutions. This is established in 1990. And IAS 31, financial reporting of interest in joint ventures, this is established in 1990. IAS 32, this is financial instruments disclosure and presentation. This is what related disclosure presentation of events and financial instrument information or statement. This is established in 1995. And IAS 32 only the standards are fixed for that. IAS 33, earning per share, EPS, earning per share related to policies and others, these are shown in the IAS 33. It is established in 1997. And IAS 34 is established in 1998. This is related to interim financial reporting, means how to prepare report at an interim period. Regarding this standards and policies and strategies are fixed in IAS 34. IAS 35 related discontinuing operations, means any entity, means sole trading or partnership firm and etc. which are come to discontinue. What is the policies are followed? That should be shown in IAS 35, that is established in 1998. And IAS 36 is established in 1998 related to impairment of assets. Impairment of assets. IAS 37 is related to 1998 and established related to provisions, contingent liabilities and contingent assets. Very important related to what are the provisions which are followed, contingent liabilities and contingent assets and policies and strategies related to this one which are established in IAS 37. And IAS 38 related to intangible assets, not tangible, it is intangible assets which are related to what are the policies related to intangible assets and strategies and guidelines related to this one. That is what we call established in IAS 38, which is established in 1998. And IAS 39, the standards are fixed in that financial instruments like recognition, measurement and etc. in 1998. And IAS 40 related to investment property, that is asset, investment property, that is established in 2000 regarding policies and strategies related to investment property, that is shown in IAS 40. And IAS 41, that is what is the policies or strategies or guidelines which are followed for agriculture, books of accounts are maintained. That is established in 2000. That's shown in IAS 41. These are the international accounting standards which are established by the IASC, means International Accounting Standards Committee. These are just 41 international accounting standards are there. These are listed out only and it is not related any explanation. Therefore, for any 2 marks mentioned before or any 5 marks mentioned, just IAS means International Accounting Standards, AAS means Accounting Standards of India, okay na? ದೆರ್ಫೋರ್ ನಾವು ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಅಕೌಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿದ್ವಿ, ಈಗ ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಅಕೌಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ನೋಡಿದ್ವಿ. ನಿಮಗೆ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಇರಲಿ, ಅಟ್ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಯಾವುದಾದ್ರು ಒಂದು ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಅಕೌಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, AS1, AS2, AS3 ಯಾವ್ದು ಅಂತ ನೀವು ತಿಳ್ಕೋಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಅಕೌಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ಸ್. ದೆರ್ಫೋರ್ ಅಕೌಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ನಾನು ನಾಲ್ಕು ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಅನ್ನು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ, ನಾಲ್ಕು ವಿಡಿಯೋಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ 1 ಇಂಟ್ರಡಕ್ಷನ್, ಮೀನಿಂಗ್, ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಶ್ಯೂಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಿಗ್ನಿಫಿಕೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಸ್ ಬಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ. ಎಸ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ 2 ಐ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೀಜರ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಕೌಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ ಬೋರ್ಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವಿಸ್ ಅಥಾರಿಟಿ ಟು ಇಶ್ಯೂ ದ ಅಕೌಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ, ಅದನ್ನು ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ. ಅಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ 3 ಲಿಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಅಕೌಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ಅಂಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ 4 ಲಿಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಅಕೌಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಇಷ್ಟನ್ನು ನೀವು ನೋಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಓದ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಸಾಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ವೆರಿ ಮಚ್.